ويسمى حصير يطوى.
So this is the fitna or the fitan, the trials, that they are laid out in the same way that a mat is rolled out.
كعرف الحصير عودا عودا.
In the same way that the hasir is rolled out bit by bit.
شوفوا لنا مناديل. تشوف. فما أنكرها يعني ردها من هذه الأمور التي تعرض على القلب. فما أنكرها نكت في قلبه نكتة بيضاء.
And if the heart rejects this shubha, then there is placed on it a white dot.
وما قد قبلها أي وقع فيها نكت في قلبه نكتة سوداء.
And that which the heart accepts or it falls into, then a black dot is placed upon the heart.
فهذين القلبين هذا مستمر في رد الشهوات والشبهات والفتن فيزداد هذا القلب بياضا وذاك يقبل الشهوات والشبهات فينكت في قلبه فيزداد سوادا.
So these two hearts, they differ. That the first one of them, the heart that rejects the desires, and the doubts, that white dots are placed on it until it becomes white. And the second heart is the one that it accepts the desires and the doubts, and black dots are placed on it up until the heart becomes black entirely.
حتى تصبح القلوب قلبين أبيض كالصفا يعني كالثلج بياضا لا يضره فتنة ما دامت السماوات والأرض وقلب أسود مرباد كالكوز مجخيا لا يعرف معروفا ولا ينكر منكرا.
And these two hearts, the one that is white, that it becomes so white that it becomes like the white of the ice or the snow. And this remains up until the heavens and the earth remain. And the black heart, it becomes so black. حتى القلب الأبيض
يصبح مربادا أسود يعني شديد السواد.
That it becomes extremely black because of it accepting all the doubts.
كالكوز مجخيا.
الكوز المجخية.
الكوب المقلوب أو الإناء الذي وضع أعلاه على أسفل. So, قلب.
Like a cup that is turned upside down.
إيكاس. كالكوز مجخية.
ما معنى المجخية؟
أي مقلوب أعلاه على أسفل. أنا طلبت كاس حتى أشرح ذلك. هذا كوز مجخية أي مقلوب.
So it is turned upside down.
ما أتى لا يقبل شيء لأنه فتحة القبول قد سدت.
So no matter what is poured onto it or you try to pour into it, that it does not accept anything because it has been turned upside down.
كالكوز مجخيا.
Like a cup that has been turned upside down. So this black heart becomes like that cup which is turned upside down. But no matter what you pour into it, it doesn't accept it. جميل.
ما شاء. شوفوا هنا شيء ساخن. أتى الكوب لازم. فتصبح القلوب قلبين.
So the hearts, they are of two types.
وأنت أعرف الناس بقلبك.
And you are the most knowledgeable of your own heart.
من خلال ما تترك لله وما تقع في معصية الله.
And this is that you know your own heart because you know what you have left off for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you know what you have fallen into of disobedience to Allah ta'ala.
أنواع القلوب.
How many types of hearts are there?
قلب ميت.
A dead heart.
وقلب حي
and a heart that is alive
وقلب مريض
and a heart that is sick.
ما هي حياة القلوب?
What is that that brings about life of the heart or life to the heart?
التوحيد.
It is التوحيد or monotheism.
اتباع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم
and following the sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم.
الطاعة.
Obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
من العبادة.
By performing ibadah or acts of worship and remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala
والدُعَاء
and making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
هذه حياة القلوب.
نعم.
هذه حياة القلوب.
And this is the life of the heart.
ولذلك حياة القلوب بالتوحيد والطاعة والاتباع.
And this is why life of the hearts is through التوحيد, worshiping Allah سبحانه وتعالى alone, and it is through being obedient to Allah سبحانه وتعالى and following the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وموت القلوب بالشرك والبدع والمعاصي هي الذنوب.
And death of the hearts occurs through committing shirk or associating partners to Allah Ta'ala, as well as bid'ah or innovations and being disobedient to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala.
رأيت الذنوب تميت القلوب وقد يورث الذل إدمانها وترك الذنوب حياة القلوب وخير لنفسك عصيانها.
And the poet, he said that I saw that disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings about darkness to the heart. And that which brings about life to the heart, he says, is being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
مثل الذي يذكر الله والذي لا يذكر الله مثل الحي والميت.
The example of the one who remembers Allah ta'ala and the one who does not remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like the likeness of or the comparison between a person who is dead and the one who is alive.
إذا رأيت أنك واقع في الشركيات وتارك للصلوات ومقترف للذنوب والمعاصي والمنكرات ارجع إلى الله أنت ميت قلبك.
And if you see yourself involved or you are busy with shirk or acts of shirk, and if you have involved yourself in being disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by leaving of the five salawat, then know that this is a sign for you to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to be obedient to Him.
إياك أن تموت.
Beware of dying you yourself.
وقلبك ميت.
And your heart is dead.
فهناك في الناس أحياء ولكن قلوبهم ميتة.
And there are some people who are alive, but their hearts, they are dead.
حياة القلوب سلامتها.
That life of the heart is that which brings about peace to it and safety.
من ماذا سلامتها؟
يعني that it is safe from what?
من الشك والشرك.
From doubts.
والبدع والذنوب والمعاصي.
And innovations and sins and being disobedient to Allah Ta'ala.
سليم سالم من ذلك من أهل التوحيد والاتباع والطاعة.
And those who are safe and they are sound from it, that they are the people of التوحيد and following the Sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم.
هذا الذي ينجو يوم القيامة.
This is the one who will be saved on the day of قيامة.
ما الدليل?
And what is the proof for this?
إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ.
Except the one who comes to Allah Ta'ala with a heart that is safe.
سليم من ماذا؟
It is safe from what?
من الشرك.
From shirk.
أن يدعو غير الله.
And the shirk, such as calling upon other than Allah Ta'ala.
يذبح لغير الله.
Or he slaughters for other than Allah Ta'ala.
يستغيث بغير الله.
Or he seeks the assistance in other than Allah Ta'ala.
يتوكل على غير الله.
Or he depends on other than Allah Ta'ala.
هذا قلب مريض.
That this is the sign of a heart that is sick.
فليصل إلى درجة الموت.
And it reaches up to the level where it is dead.
أنقذ نفسك.
So save yourself.
بأن تحيا القلوب.
By reviving your heart and bringing it back to life.
بماذا؟
And how is this done?
بمثل هذه المجالس.
By sitting in these types of gatherings.
في بيوت الله.
In the houses of Allah.
تسمع العلم.
By listening to knowledge.
تسمع قال الله.
And listening to Allah Ta'ala said.
تسمع قال رسول الله.
And hearing the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said.
هذه من علامات التوفيق لك.
And this are from the signs of التوفيق that Allah Ta'ala has given you ability.
هذه من علامات الخيرية لك.
And these are from the signs of good for you.
يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم he said.
من يريد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين.
Whoever Allah Ta'ala desires good for, that Allah Ta'ala gives him understanding in the religion.
معنى من لا يريد الله به خير لا يفقهه في الدين. هذا شر.
And this is the opposite of it is true, is that whoever Allah Ta'ala does not want good for him, that Allah Ta'ala does not give him understanding in the religion.
من يريد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين.
That whoever Allah Ta'ala desires good for, that Allah Ta'ala gives him understanding in the deen, in the religion.
يفقهه في الدين. أجلسه في الأخير.
That he gives him understanding.
أجلسه في الأخير. أجلسه في الأخير. أجلسه في الأخير. أجلسه في الأخير. من لا يريد الله به خير.
Who Allah Ta'ala does not want good for him?
لا يفقهه في الدين.
That he is not given understanding of the deen.
إذا رأيت أن الله أخذ بناصيتك فأجلسك في مجالس العلم.
And if you see that Allah Ta'ala has taken you by your forelock and brought you to sit in the gatherings of knowledge,
فاعلم أن الله أراد بك خير.
Then know that Allah Ta'ala wants good for you.
جاهد نفسك.
Strive against yourself.
استمر.
Continue.
من يريد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين.
That whoever Allah Ta'ala wants good for, Allah Ta'ala gives him understanding in the religion.
خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه.
That he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam he said that the best of you are those who learn the Quran and they teach it.
خيرية كاملة.
That this is complete goodness.
أن يعينك تتعلم ثم تعلم.
That Allah Ta'ala aids you upon learning and then you teach.
من أراد أن يعلم قبل أن يتعلم بماذا سيتكلم؟ لا تتكلم إلا بعد أن تتعلم.
That whoever wants to teach but he hasn't learned, then what is he going to speak with? So don't speak until you have learned.
القلب السليم.
The heart that is safe and sound.
الحي.
Is the one which is alive.
إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم.
But when Allah
وإذا تليت عليهم آيات زادتهم إيمانا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون.
But when the ayat, when Allah Ta'ala is mentioned, that their hearts begin to tremble and quiver. And when the ayat of Allah Ta'ala are recited to them, وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ, that it increases them in iman. And they are the ones who place their reliance in Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala.
أنت مخلوق.
You are created.
كما في حديث الطويل.
As it comes in a lengthy hadith.
جمع الإنسان أربعين وأربعين وأربعين ثم قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ألا وإن في الجسد مضغة.
That he mentions in this hadith that a person is created and the stages of creation are mentioned over 40 days and 40 days and 40 days. And then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that is there not in the body a morsel of flesh?
إذا صلحت ألا وإن في الجسد مضغة إذا صلحت ها؟ وإذا فسدت فصلاحك وفسادك يتبع هذا القلب.
So this piece of flesh that is mentioned in this hadith of Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that when that morsel of flesh, if it is corrected, then the rest of the body becomes corrected. And your salah or rectification and your corruption, it relies or it is dependent upon this heart of yours.
أَلَا وَإِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ مُضْغَةً إِذَا صَلُحَتْ صَلُحَ سَائِرُ الْجَسَدِ وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ سَائِرُ الْجَسَدِ. إذن عليك بصلاح القلب بالتوحيد والاتباع والطاعة.
So when the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions in the second part of this hadith that he says that when the heart becomes or when this morsel of flesh becomes corrupt, then the rest of the body will become corrupt. So upon you is to rectify your hearts by at-tawheed and being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and following the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
مسلم شروط كثيرة ذهني إن شاء الله سيأتي
عسل عسل.
ذات يوم كان النبي مع أصحاب.
One day the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم was with his companions.
فقال لهم
and he said to them,
إن الله لا ينظر إلى صوركم ولا إلى أموالكم وأتى ولا إلى أجسادكم.
As he said to his companions, that verily Allah Ta'ala does not look at your physical form or your bodies, nor at your wealth.
ولكن ينظر إلى قلوبكم وأعمالكم.
But rather he looks at your hearts and at your actions.
فالقلوب من جهة الإخلاص والأعمال من جهة المتابعة.
And when it is mentioned that Allah Ta'ala looks at your hearts, then it means that Allah Ta'ala looks at your sincerity.
فإن أخلص.
And when Allah Ta'ala looks at your أعمال, إلى أموالكم.
إن الله لا ينظر إلى صوركم وأموالكم وأتى في أجسادكم لكن ينظر إلى قلوبكم وأعمالكم.
And looking at your actions means that he looks at your following of the sunnah.
فالقلوب من جهة الإخلاص والأعمال من جهة المتابعة. فعمل لا إخلاص فيه وعبادة لا متابعة فيها كلها مردودة.
So an action,
قبول العبادة الإخلاص والمتابعة.
An action in which there is no ikhlas, there is no sincerity to Allah Ta'ala in it, and there is no following of the sunnah of our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, these are actions which are rejected. So the two conditions for the acceptance of the actions is that a person is mukhlis or is sincere in his actions and he follows the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is the meaning of the heart that is safe and sound.
فالقلب المريض إما من جهة الشركيات أو من جهة البدعيات.
So the heart that is sick is either that it falls into shirkiyat or associating parties with Allah Ta'ala, or it is that which is involved in bid'ah or innovation.
هذا في مسائل التعبد.
And these are relating to the affairs of worship.
أو في جوانب الذنوب والمعاصي التي يمارسها الإنسان.
Or it also means, or it looks at the sins or the disobediences that the heart falls into.
فعليك أن تعتني بقلبك.
So upon you is to have a great concern for your heart.
تفقد نفسك.
That don't that look after yourself and take care of it.
تفقدها. يقول ابن مسعود إذا سمعت الله تبارك وتعالى يقول يا أيها الذين آمنوا فرع لها سمعك إما أمر تؤمر به فامتثل أو نهي تنهى عنه فاجتنب.
عبد الله بن مسعود he said that when you hear Allah سبحانه وتعالى saying يا أيها الذين آمنوا or you who believe and pay attention. For either it is that Allah Ta'ala is ordering you with something, so act upon it. Or Allah Ta'ala is prohibiting you from something, so stay away from it.
فكيف أنت مع الأوامر والنواهي؟
So how are you with the orders of Allah Ta'ala and the prohibitions of Allah?
في عينك.
In your own eyes, how do you see yourself?
في سمعك.
With your eyes or with your hearing,
فرجك.
With your privates,
بطنك.
With your stomach,
مالك.
With your wealth,
كل شيء.
In everything,
راقب الله.
Beware of Allah Ta'ala.
وكل ما تكون مراقب لله عز وجل.
And the more you are aware and beware of Allah Ta'ala,
كل ما تكون على خير. جيب اللي معك.
The more you will be upon goodness.
ولذلك.
And that is why.
جاهد نفسك.
Strive against your soul.
جاهدها. جاهدها.
Strive.
لماذا أجاهدها؟
Why should I strive against my soul?
بماذا؟ ليس لماذا. بماذا أجاهدها؟
What should I strive against my soul?
بقوله عز وجل والذين جاهدوا فينا لنهدينهم سبلنا وإن الله لمع المحسنين.
How do we strive against ourselves? And this is through reflecting upon the ayah that Allah سبحانه وتعالى says that those who strive with regards to us.
صديق.
But those who strive with regards to us, that Allah Ta'ala says, لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ that we will guide them towards the paths of guidance. لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَ السَّلَامِ that we will guide them towards our paths. And verily Allah Ta'ala is with those who are doing good or the good doers.
حَتَّى يَكُونَ اللَّهُ مَعَكَ فإذا كان معك حفظك.
So that Allah Ta'ala is with you. يعني when you strive against your soul, and when Allah Ta'ala. So when you strive against yourself, that Allah Ta'ala will be with you.
وأعانك على نفسك.
And He will assist you against yourself.
وأخذ بناصيتك حيثما أمرك وصرفك عن ما نهاك.
And He will take you by your forelock and guide you to that which He has ordered you with, and He will steer you away from that which He has prohibited you
from. لأن الله تولاك.
Because Allah Ta'ala is the one who has taken
فأصبحت وليا.
So you become an ally of Allah.
فيحفظ جوارحك.
So Allah Ta'ala preserves your limbs.
من الذي أتى بكم للمسجد؟
Who is it that brought you to the masjid?
Allah.
Allah Ta'ala.
جلسكم في مجلس العلم.
That He made you sit in this gathering of knowledge.
كثير سمعوا بالدرس والإعلان والمسجد والصلاة. نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا.
So many people they have heard that there is going to be a lesson tonight. Many people have heard that but the call to Salah, but many have not come. And Allah Ta'ala says. That Allah Ta'ala speaks in the Quran and warns us against, and we make this dua. The dua the Shaykh made was that we seek a refuge from the evil of our own selves.
إذا سمعنا المؤذن يقول حي على الصلاة. ماذا نقول؟
What should we say when we hear the muadhin saying, "Come towards the salah"?
عندك ماذا يقول؟
What should we say when the muadhin says, "حي على الصلاة"?
تا. أنت تا. أيوة تا. هذه هدية لك. يقول لا حول ولا قوة ممتاز ما شاء الله. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله، ليس بحولي ولا بقوتي، إنما أنت الذي أعنتني وأخذت بي فأتيت بي أن أكون عبدا ساجدا راكعا مع المصلين واركعوا مع الراكعين.
So when we say this after the Muadhin has said Hayya ala Salah, come towards the Salah, and after saying Hayya ala Falah also, that we say from the Sunnah is that we say that there is no might, no power except with Allah Ta'ala. And it is Allah Ta'ala that brings you to the Masjid, that He leads you here and He makes you from those who make sujood with the Musallin or those who make the Salah. Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, وَارْكَعُوا مَعَ الرَّاكِعِينَ that bow with those who bow.
إذن صلاح القلوب له ميزان له قياس.
So there is for rectification of the hearts that there is a measure.
كيف نقيسه؟
How do we measure?
كيف نحن مع الله؟
How are we with Allah?
أنا لا أعرف عن قلبي.
I don't know anything about my heart. You know your heart.
كيف تعرف قلبك؟
How do you know your heart?
صليت اليوم في المسجد.
Did you pray in the masjid today?
الفجر.
Did you pray Fajr?
مع الجماعة.
With the جماعة.
الظهر.
Did you pray ظهر؟
العصر.
And عصر.
المغرب.
And مغرب.
ماذا؟
What
بك يا عبد الله؟
What is with you, O servant of Allah?
أكلت الحلال؟
Did you eat that which is
ولا حرام؟
Or did you eat حرام؟
نظرت الحرام؟
Did you look at that which
سمعت
is حرام؟
الحرام؟
Or listen to that which is حرام؟
مارست الحرام؟
Did you do that which is حرام؟
سعيت في الحرام؟
Did you start
with that
which is حرام؟
كذب؟
Did you lie؟
الغيبة؟
Did you backbite someone؟
النميمة؟
Did you gossip about
الخطوات
someone؟
في الباطل؟
Did you walk towards that which is falsely؟ Did you steal something؟
السرقة من الناس.
Was stealing from the people.
الاعتداء والضرب.
Or having animosity towards someone or hitting someone.
مجموعة أشياء تقيس بها من أنت.
There are many things through which you measure yourself.
فتعرف صلاحك من فسادك.
So you know your rectification from your corruption or being corrupted.
اللهم اصلح قلوبنا.
We ask Allah Ta'ala to correct our hearts.
القلوب إذا صلحت.
But when the hearts are corrected or they are rectified,
عشت في طريق الجنة قبل دخول الجنة.
That you have lived on the path of Jannah before you entered into it.
والله.
By Allah.
من وحد الله واتبع وأطاع إنه ليعيش في طريق الجنة.
That the one who singles out Allah Ta'ala when he worships him.
فأما من
and he is
أعطى
obedient to him.
واتقى وصدق بالحسنى فسنيسره لليسرى.
But when you are singling out Allah Ta'ala, worshipping Him alone, when you are obedient to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, then you have lived in the path of Jannah, or you have lived upon Jannah. And that means that whoever fears Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala.
فمن سار إلى الله وصل.
That whoever travels to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, that he will reach Allah.
ومن قطع الطريق على نفسهم فصل.
And whoever cuts off the path for his nafs, that he will fail. That he will be cut off.
أنت.
So you.
أنقذ نفسك.
Save yourself.
فإنقاذك لها سلامتك.
Because through saving yourself, you will be safe.
نحن قدمنا الآن من السفر.
That we have just come from a travel.
فكان الجو بارد.
The weather was cold.
فيبدو أن نخاف أن لا يأتينا فنأخذ احتياطنا فالصوت بدأ يتغير. وهذا من الأسباب.
So the Sheikh says that it appears that the weather has had some effect on his voice because it is cold. We came from Durban, and we are taking this just to prevent any.
والدكتور نصحني بهذا الدواء.
ترجمة.
دكتور told me. think like this one, it will be healthy. You are this healthy, inshallah. And you make sure everything good. أصلح قلبك.
Rectify your heart.
إذا ما خلوت الدهر يوما فلا تقل خلوت ولكن قل علي رقيب ولا تحسب أن الله يغفل ساعة ولا أن ما تخفي عليه يغيب رقب الله.
So beware of Allah. If there is a day in a year that you have not reflected and you have introspected or looked into yourself, then you will not rectify yourself.
إذا ما خلوت بريبة في ظلمة والنفس داعية إلى الطغيان فاستح من نظر الإله وقل لها إن الذي خلق الظلام يراني.
So when you are with yourself, introspect, reflect, because when you are left to yourself or when you are in disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then reflect and remember and remember that Allah ta'ala is watching you and He is looking at you.
ما الذي يمنعنا من الحرام؟
من
الحرام.
What is it that prevents us from haram?
قد تهيأ لك وتستطيع أن تمارس ما تريد.
It could be easy for you to do and for you to do that particular sin.
خوف الله.
It is fearing Allah ta'ala.
ومحبته.
And loving Allah ta'ala.
ورجاء ما عنده.
And hoping for that which is with Allah ta'ala.
حب الله.
And this is, we do it through
loving,
because we love Allah ta'ala, that we follow His orders.
ننتهي عن نهي.
And we stay away from His
عقابه.
And we fear from the punishment of
وعذابه وناره.
And the fire and the punishment that He has prepared.
وسخطه وعقوبته.
And from the anger and the punishment of Allah ta'ala.
ورجاء رحمته.
And you hope for the mercy of Allah.
وجنته.
And His jannah.
ورضاه.
And His pleasure.
فعلنا ما أمرنا به وتركنا ما نهانا عنه إنها التقوى.
And if we stay away or we do that which Allah Ta'ala has ordered us with, and we stay away from that which Allah Ta'ala has prohibited us from, then verily this is التقوى. We're having fear of Allah Ta'ala.
إنها التقوى.
This is التقوى.
أن تجعل بينك وبين عذاب الله وقاية بفعل أوامره وترك نواهيه.
And taqwa is that you place between yourself and Allah Ta'ala a shield. And this is done by acting upon that which Allah Ta'ala has ordered you with and staying away from the prohibitions of Allah.
كيف تعرف صلاح قلبك؟
How do you know that your heart has been rectified?
الناس اتق الله حيثما كنت.
Our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that fear Allah Ta'ala wherever you are.
خالق الناس بخلق حسن.
And deal with the people with good character.
واتبع السيئه الحسنه تمحوها.
And follow up a bad deed with a good deed that it will expiate it.
مع النفس.
It will remove it. But with the people.
مع نفسك.
And with yourself.
مع ربك.
And with your Lord.
الله. مقاييس لصلاح القلوب.
That these are measures for rectification of the heart.
إذا قلبي يؤلمني ذهبت للطبيب وقلت عالجني فأعطاني حبوب ومسيلات لعلاج هذا القلب.
So when I am sick or I feel a pain in my heart,
مرض جسدي,
I go to the doctor and the doctor gives me, or I say to the doctor, this is from the diseases or a physical disease that you have.
أنت تعرف أن قلبك مريض.
And you know that your heart is sick. That is.
لذلك ذهبت للطبيب.
And that is why you went to the doctor.
وإذا تركت العلاج. وتشعر به.
That you will feel it, the illness will increase.
وتذهب للطبيب. إذا فرطت في العلاج ربما يضرك بل ربما تموت.
And if you are lax about the medication that you must take, that it might harm you even more than illness. You might die from it.
ومع ذلك.
And despite that.
نبذل الأموال لعلاج قلوبنا.
That we spend money to cure our hearts.
لأن مرضها يتعبنا ويؤذينا.
Because when our heart is sick, it is something which makes us tired and it makes us ill.
يا هذا انتبه.
So, oh, you who has this, or who, the one who does this.
ماذا عن قلبك مع الله؟
What about your heart with Allah?
وأنت تعرف أنك مريض.
And you know that you are sick.
مريض بشهوة النساء.
That you are sick with desires for women.
مريض بالاعتداء في الأموال والنهب والكذب والغش.
That you are sick through various things like being stingy with your money.
مريض.
Or you are lying or you are gossiping.
مريض في لسانك بالكذب والغيبة والسب واللعن.
And you are sick through your tongue that you lie and you gossip and you curse or you swear.
مريض في حق ربك.
You are sick with regards to the rights of your Rabb or your Lord over you.
مريض في حق والديك.
You are sick with regards to the rights of your parents over you.
مع زوجك وأبنائك وجيرانك وقرابتك وأرحامك وزملائك والناس.
But you are sick when it comes in your heart with regards to your wife and children and your family and your neighbors. That you are sick when it comes in your heart with regards to them.
صلاح القلوب.
Rectification of the heart.
يحتاج مجاهدة.
It requires that you strive against yourself.
فعليك أن تهتم وهو ليس فيه بذل مال.
So it gives you a great concern which spending money.
بل فيه رضا من الرحمن.
And in it there is pleasure from Allah that Allah Ta'ala is pleased with you.
فسيكون الله معك.
نعم شيخ.
فسيكون معك.
And Allah Ta'ala will be with you.
ويعافي بدنك.
And He will protect your body.
فأصلح بالهم.
And He will
يصلح correct ذريتك.
And He will correct your
ويبارك
intellect.
في رزقك.
And He will bless you in your rizq.
ويبارك في وقتك.
And He will bless you in your time.
وامتثلت أمرك.
Through that you have
الذي الموت ما توكل على الله بقلب سليم.
And this is eternal happiness that when he dies, that he reaches or he comes to Allah Ta'ala with a heart that is safe and sound.
هذا صلاح القلوب.
And this is rectification of the heart.
أسأل الله يصلح قلوبنا.
We ask Allah Ta'ala to rectify our hearts.
ويكفينا وإياكم شرور أنفسنا.
And that He frees us from the evils of our hearts.
وسيئات أعمالنا.
And the evil of our actions.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته وصلى الله وسلم على محمد. وقت الأذان. أذن.
Yes,
إن شاء الله.
Sheikh will answer some questions after.